हेलो गाइस, माय नेम इज़ हरदविंदर। वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फार्मूलाज एंड फंक्शंस इन स्प्रेडशीट। दिस आर सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ सेवंथ क्लास, फार्मूलाज एंड फंक्शंस इन स्प्रेडशीट। इन दिस सेशन वी विल कवर फार्मूलाज इन एक्शन, एक्सेल, क्रिएटिंग बेसिक फार्मूलाज, यूजिंग कंपाउंड फार्मूलाज, यूजिंग फार्मूलाज ऑन टेस्ट, सैलरीज, सेल्स रेफरेंसेज एंड इट्स टाइप्स। तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज़ फार्मूला? फार्मूला यू यूज इन मैथमेटिक्स आल्सो, इन एक्सेल सेम लाइक फार्मूला। फार्मूलाज आर यूज टू परफॉर्म कैलकुलेशंस इन्वॉल्विंग एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, डिवीजन एंड मल्टीप्लिकेशन एटसेट्रा। अ फार्मूला मस्ट बिगिन विद इक्वल टू सिंबल फॉलोड बाय सेल रेफरेंस एंड एट ऑपरेटर्स। फार्मूलाज यू यूज इन मैथमेटिक्स आल्सो, फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग अ एरिया ऑफ अ रेक्टेंगल यू यूज अ फार्मूला, length multiplied by breadth. Similarly, in Excel, in spreadsheet, we can use a lot of formulas for calculations, for simple and complex calculations, all type of calculations like addition, subtraction, division and multiplication, etc. Let us take an example. Suppose I want to take the sum of all these marks of different students. I want to calculate the total marks like English, Punjabi, Hindi, Math, Science, Social Science, Computer, how much total he has, the particular students got. For that we have to create a formula. Very first thing in Excel, if you want to write a formula, very first thing you need to write the is equal to sign. This is a formula bar. Whatever you will write here, it will show here in a formula bar. So very first thing you need to write a is equal to sign, is equal to. Then we have to calculate the sum of all these values, 10 plus 18 plus 17 plus 15 plus 16 plus 19. Instead of writing the values, we will use the reference of that values. For getting a reference of that value, I can click here. This is 10. This is written in C7. You can see here C7. C7 means this is the address of that cell. Means C column. And 7 denotes the row. These the cell address is a combination of two coordinates. C means alphabet and a number. Alphabet denotes the column name and number denotes the row name. So this is a 10 is written in that cell in the reference of C7. The value in the C7, instead of giving exact value, we have given the reference of that cell. Then plus, we can click here, it will automatically come. Reference will automatically come when we will use equal to sign, and then after that use the operator and click that particular cell. Or you can write by hand also, manually also, but it's better you can use pick the reference by clicking this plus F7 plus signs plus 16, then plus 19, then press enter. It's showing formula. So the sum of all these values has been shown. I think you have understood. Once again I will tell you, very first thing in formula you need to write the equal to sign, then plus, then cell address plus the address of that cell, then plus, then this cell, then again plus this. You can write in this formula bar also, and here, then this, then this, then press enter. So students, you don't need to calculate the formula for you don't need to write a formula separately for each row. You can copy the formula. Suppose I have written here, I can copy all the formula drop down. Just you can click here cell pointer, and when this mouse cursor will go in this corner, right bottom corner, when thus your mouse pointer will take this shape, plus shape, then click the mouse and drag it down. Automatically the sum of all rows has been calculated. means you don't need to write the formula for every row again and again. In this way you can do the simple basic formula, means you need to write the is equal to sign and then this is called a reference plus or multiplication or division, whatever the operation you want to perform, that particular operator you can use. These are called the operators, plus, minus, multiplication, division. These are the operators. Which operation you want to do, that particular operator you can use here. Then addresses of all the cells, and then plus, I suppose I want to do the sum of all these values, so I use the plus addition operator in all these references. Then press enter, and you don't need to write the formula again and again. You can just drag down like this. Suppose I have pick and cut it, click here, and take your mouse in the right bottom corner. When the mouse pointer will take the shape of this plus sign, then click the mouse and drag down. All the formulas will be copied automatically. You can see here we have written C7, D7, E7. When we copied the formula here, it automatically changed. C7, now it's in C8, like this. Here we want these values, C8. Here is 8. Earlier it was 7. Now we need 8. So automatically it's changing its reference when we are copying. This is called as relative reference, means relatively. When we are copying the formula downwards or rightwards or leftwards, then when you are dragging the formula, the reference of that cell automatically means relatively changing. This is called a relative reference. If suppose we don't want that, when we are copying the formula, it should not change its reference, then we can use the absolute reference, that we will also learn. Now when the cell reference is automatically changing, that is called a relative reference. Again I'm telling you, here we didn't write the formula manually, we copied the formula here. Here automatically, here the values are C8, here automatically it has been changed to C9, D9, here it automatically changed to C10. This is called a relative reference, means automatically the reference relatively it's changing. This is a relative reference. So this is a basic formula. In a basic formula, we use only a single operator, means only addition operator we have used. Now we will calculate a percentage. For calculating a percentage, what is the formula? The formula for calculating a percentage is obtained marks divided by total marks. Obtained marks means the marks how much a student got, divided by total marks from how much he or she has got, multiplied by 100. So here we are using three operators, two operators, multiply and division. Obtained marks divided by total marks multiplied by 100, means two operators we are using, more than one operator, means in the earlier we have used only a single operator plus. Here we are using two operators, multiply and division. So that's why it is called a compound formula. In compound formula we will use more than one operators. So here we will calculate the percentage here, this, and where are the total marks? Total marks are here. We don't need to write the 112 manually. We will click here. It will pick the reference of that cell. Divide by total marks. How much total marks? Suppose all are of 25. 25 plus 25, 50. 50 plus 25, 75. 75 plus 25, 100. 125. Next, 150. And 175. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 means 175. Suppose each subject maximum marks 25. So total marks will be, I think these all subjects are out of 20. All marks are less, 125. Okay. 175 marks are total marks. Multiply by 100. We are using three operators. This is first operator, second operator, this division is the first operator, this multiplication is the second operator, and this is a total marks. These are the 175 is a maximum marks and multiply by 100. So hence here total marks will change. Suppose first student has 112 marks, second 180 marks, 115 marks, but 175 and 100, they will remain same. So these are called the constants. Constants are the values which will remain same, which won't change. Suppose I will calculate this particular student scored 64% marks. When we will drag down, all values will be calculated. Suppose we want to reduce the points, you can click here to reduce the or increase the points. So students, when we are copying the formula from here to here, you can see here it's a J7 and here it is J8. The reference is changing J7 to J8, but 175 and 100, they will remain same. So these are called the constants, the values which won't change while we are copying the formula. That those values are called the constants, and the values which will change, that is called a variable. So this is the operators, multiplication and divisions are the operators, and this is a variable or reference, or these are the constants, 175 and 100. So in this way we can create the compound formula. For maximum marks, by mistake I have written 700, these are 175. Instead of writing manually, I want to pick this 175. Instead of writing manually, I want to give the reference of this cell K5. So means same, earlier we have written manually, but now I have given the reference of that value. So that is the same. When we will drag down, what's happening? Because when we are copying formula here, it's here it is K5, but when we are copying here, it is K6, means it is changing. When we are dragging down, it relatively it's changing the reference, but we don't want. We want this value should change, this total reference should change. In J7 to J8 we want that should change, but we don't want this K5 value should change. So we need to make it a constant. For making it constant, we can press F4. So when we will press F4, with both the coordinates K and 5, these are two coordinates of that particular cell, will be prefixed by dollar sign. That means now it's an absolute reference. Now when we will copy the formula, it won't change. Now so you can say here is K5 again. When you are coming here, this J7 to J8, but K5 will remain same. Here K5 will remain same. Means when you want that when we are copying the formula, the value, that reference should not change, then we need to make this reference as an absolute reference. So for making absolute reference, we have to prefix a dollar sign with the coordinates. Means K and 5 both are the coordinates. We want to make them constant. We have to prefix this dollar sign with both of them. Or you can simply put the cursor here. We can press the F4 from keyboard. It will automatically become an absolute reference. So absolute reference means when we are copying the formula, the value should not change. The reference should not change. That is called absolute reference. When we want that, when we are copying the formula, the value, then reference should change. That is called a relative reference. So this is a basic formula, or this is a compound formula. Again, I am reminding you, don't forget to put is equal to sign while writing a formula. So I think you have understood this absolute reference, relative reference, basic formula and compound formula in spreadsheet. Later on we will learn more cell range, different functions in our spreadsheet. These things we will learn in the next session. Thank you. Hope you have learned.